So today we are at Presque Isle Park, which is a day use park in the middle of Marquette County, or Marquette City actually. And it's a really nice park. There's my Jeep way over there. But there's no camping here, it's just used for day use hikes and bikes and stuff like that. And this is one of the scenic overlooks onto Lake Superior. And there occasionally can be seen black bear, lots and lots of deer. And last winter we had some moose back here. So there's all kinds of wildlife that you can come in and see. It's really fun to come out here in the winter time because you can follow the tracks around. But there's Lake Superior. Those islands out there, I've kayaked out to a few times. They're a lot of fun to play around on. You can camp out on those islands if you wanted to, but it gets quite rough at night sometimes. Most of the trails are groomed like this that are in this park. But even though it has groomed trails and a little paved route through it for doing a drive-through if you wanted, it's still a really nice place to come. Really nice place to ride your mountain bikes and stuff through in the spring, summer, and early fall. And in a second, I'm going to get back in my Jeep. And we're going to drive around and show you some other fun points about this place. So, let's see here. I think the next stop is going to be another scenic overlook right down this road. And then there's one place called Black Rock that I want to show you. It's really nice. So, we'll see you there. Here we are driving down the one and only road through here. It's a really nice scenic drive. The speed limit is 15 miles per hour. And any faster and you really miss a lot of stuff that goes on in the wilderness here. Had a lot of wind damage this summer, and there's a squirrel crossing the road. But last week we had a major freeze and then a big windstorm, and we lost a lot of trees to that, just snapping off. As you can see, there's a whole lot of trails that go off and that you can walk around on and stuff, so it's pretty nice. Still over there is Lake Superior. Okay, more to come. Okay, so over there's the road. We just came off and pulled off to a side parking lot here. There's my Jeep. Came down here. This is one of the spots I wanted to show you. This section over here is called Black Rock. And this area is one of my favorite spots to bring my kayaks out and head out to go out into Lake Superior, out to the islands and stuff like that. Because it's always real calm for the most part right in here. And so you can get into the kayaks and paddle out, get situated before heading out into the rough waters. Today is actually quite calm on Lake Superior, but it's usually not like this. That section there is called Black Rock. And the kids, well, college kids, and kids of all ages, really, will come out there and they'll go out onto the edge. Right over there, there's kind of like a little overhang or cave type thing in the side of the wall. Right about that area, the water is really deep, approximately 20-25 feet, and everybody will go out and hang out on the rocks there and jump off and go diving and whatnot. It's a lot of fun. Very few people actually get hurt out here. It's amazing. But one of the reasons why I like coming out here is to watch all the girls in their bikinis jumping off the rocks and swimming. So it's a pleasant view at times here. Even without the people though, it's a really nice view. So what I'm going to do is, there's this really cool cave thing up here. So I'm going to put the camera away, climb up this ledge here, get to the top. As you can see, there's a lot of ice and whatnot, water seeping out of the mountainside. So I didn't bring my head mount, my head strap for the camera, so I'm gonna have to put it away in order to get up to the top safely. It'd be really cool if I could get a close-up video of the side of the rock there, but you're gonna have to do from here. It's really nice though. So, okay, I'll meet you up top. Okay, I'm up top now, and there's the climb. There's another view. We will be going over to that other side here shortly. But first I want to show you what's in that hole there. It's quite fun. Come over here. There's a little pond over here. Whoop. Right there. A little wading pool type thing that drains into the lake. And what fills that pool is water coming out of the mountain. And in the summertime, it's really warm. Not quite like a jacuzzi, but still pretty darn warm. Nice place to just hang out and relax. And here's pretty cool. It's this big hole down here. The water comes and does the runoff. Comes down in here, washes away all the sediment and everything that's in here and the stone. Creates this big hole. And there's a gap under there that I'm going to go around to the other side and climb in. It's very easy to climb down there, but in doing so, you're going to break up the rock and everything and the vegetation and stuff, and I don't want to damage it. So we're just going to go in the non-damaging way. It's really nice. Second, I could just jump down in there, but I don't want to break a leg or twist an ankle or something. Nobody knows I'm out here, so alrighty, just come right down over here, and I think I can hold on to the camera for this one. Alright, there we go, and we're coming down in here. Over here, and this is the little tiny little cave entrance to that hole. So the water would flow out here, comes out this way, heads down over there, and fills that little wading pool. And if you can look closely to these rocks, you can see the water actually kind of seeping out. It's really cold out here today. It's in the low 30s, so a lot of the water is frozen. So not much seepage going on, as you can see with all the snow on the rocks here. So let's crawl under there. Alrighty. It's real hard on the knees. And there we are. We just crawled underneath a mountain. Natural cave in the mountain, and here's the top. That's where I was standing a minute ago, right there. Really cool, really nice. Would not shelter here because of the fact that this is all made by runoff. Wouldn't make it a very safe place to stay. It could be raining on the other side and you not know it over here, and end up drowning you. Man, that's not quite a tight squeeze, but hard on the knees. So we're gonna come up here, And there's just so much more I want to show you, but I just can't get out there today. Because some of this, you really need dry rock to climb on. And some of it you just need water access. And I don't have my boat with me today. So, but there's a really cool area in the summertime when there's actually had some real good, if we had a real good winter and a lot of snow melt and a lot of rain in the spring, then our water tables are higher and you can actually kayak around this big chunk. But the last 2 years I have not been able to kayak around because we've been in a drought. Anybody that says we're not in a water drought is sadly mistaken. They need to come out here to Lake Superior and I'll show them actual signs of low water tables. And we're about 2 feet low right now at high tide. So, and to drain 2 feet out of Lake Superior so that the shoreline drop 2 feet is a major feat. You're talking about billions and trillions and quadrillions of gallons of water. So, but really great place. Alrighty, I'm going to turn off this and head over to the other side and turn it back on. Alright, on this side, there's another little cave crack type thing. Let's see what's in there. Now, just so y'all know, in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan, there are no poisonous snakes or scorpions or anything like that. We do have a couple of poisonous spiders up here, but other than that, this place is a really, really safe place to be. This is pretty cool. I wonder if I could squeeze out that way. Okay, I could if I had two hands, but using one hand to hold the camera, not gonna happen. So, alrighty, let's get on out of here. Now that place is a bit of a tight squeeze in there. Oh. And it comes out up there. Here, there's where we come out at. Not very high, very long, but definitely very cool. So, let's see. I'm gonna climb this up to the top of the ridge, and then turn you on and walk you out over there. So, see you in a minute. Okay, the rock is just too slick today. And can't get a good firm grip, so I'm just gonna have to take the long way up. Let's take the dirty way. How's that? This used to be carved out as steps. There we go. Oh, I'm actually breaking a sweat at 35 degrees. Estimating 35 to 33 degrees here today. If I didn't mention it already, we're only 35 minutes from my house. There's that cave we were just climbing in. And this is the shallow spot, so you don't want to jump off here. You want to go down there for jumping. Of course, I'm not going to jump in. It's the middle of a school day and a work day, which is why nobody's here but me. And people tend to avoid these areas after its first snowfall because they're treacherous. And we had our first snowfall last week, and it all melted away. I did take some video of that, but haven't uploaded it yet. Maybe I'll get it uploaded this weekend. This is a volcanic rock formation. There is, used to be, I should say, an active volcano up here. But this is the really deep area where it's perfectly safe to jump off. You can dive off of here if you want. Cannonballs, belly flops. Although, probably gonna really hurt yourself with a belly flop. I don't recall getting any video and posting it on YouTube of me kayaking around. I think that's before I got my waterproof cameras. So look forward to that next summer, because this summer I didn't really get a chance to. There we go. This is overhanging on Lake Superior. There we go. Pretty deep over here too. All this landmass here was formed hundreds, thousands of years ago. I don't know the exact timeline of history or anything on it, but you don't really need to in order to enjoy it, which is what I come out here to do. I had 4 hours to kill today, so here we are. And it just goes on for a ways down that way too. And then there's the wilderness. All right, this is getting to be a long video, I'm sure. And I don't plan on editing any of it, but I will probably end up being a two-parter. I'm gonna go ahead and shut you off here. And I'm gonna take you over to one other location that I really wanna show you. And then we'll call it good. Alrighty. All right, this is one of the family picnic areas that we're at. So they got all the grills and stuff. Not allowed to bring dogs or pets here. They don't want to scare away the wildlife. But this is a great beach to go swimming at. It's the second warmest spot in Marquette for swimming in Lake Superior in the midsummer. My wife has actually come out here in the winter every year and taken a dip and gone swimming once it freezes over. Now, she's one of those weird polar bear people that just does those freezing events in the winter time. If you look out there to that island right there, hopefully it doesn't look like it's miles and miles away on the camera, but it is a fisheye camera and it does that. But way out there is a really cool island that I will have to take you out on another day. And when you get out there, you'll see, in the future, you'll see why it is the coolest island ever. It is about a half mile out from this spot right here, kayaking. It feels like it's about 2 miles when you're kayaking it, but it's not 2 miles out. It's just strong currents and stuff. So this really is Presque Isle for the most part. Oh, way out there is one of the ore boats coming in. So all of that on the other side of the you got the shoreline over there and some buildings and stuff, but on the other side of that is all open country to go camping, hiking, mountain climbing, and all that fun stuff. So I'm gonna find out what time it is, and I have to pick up my wife at 6, but I'm supposed to see a movie at 4. So if I got a couple hours left, I'll take you up on to a couple other places. And but we'll see. That might be a video for another day. So, all right, thanks for tuning in to Fixed by Doc. Hope you enjoyed Presque Isle, and talk to you later.